إن أردتم أن تكونوا شامة بين الورى فاختفوا.
How powerful were the Russians at that time? Let me tell you how powerful they were. They had defeated the Persians. They had defeated the Turks. All the way up to China, they ruled. Nobody came in their way all the way up to China. They had Serbia, they had Mongolia, they had Poland. Even the British were concerned because if they took the Caucasus, then they would be their neighbors in India. And then they were speaking about a crusade. The Russians were speaking about a crusade. They were saying that if we take the Caucasus, then we will be able to start a new crusade. We can liberate the holy lands, the Masjid al-Aqsa. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created a man who I call the Salahuddin of the Caucasus, Imam Shamil rahimahullah. For the next quarter of a century, Imam Shamil did not allow this superpower to move. They did whatever they could, but they could not defeat Imam Shamil rahimahullah. Imam Shamil was born where? He was born in the village called Gimri in Dagestan in 1797. He belonged to a family of Avars. Avars are people who live in the Caucasus and who are very high, nine generations of very high Nasab and family. This was what his real lineage was. But the Russians didn't believe that. The Russians, when they heard about Imam Shamil and his great feats and how heroic this man was and how magnificent he was, they said, no, there's no way that this man can be a Muslim or of any other origins besides Christians. So what they said, that he was actually the son of a prince from Georgia, Christian prince, who had an ikhtilaf with his brother and who migrated to the Caucasus. And then from there he migrated to Persia. And this was his son. Meaning that Imam Shamil was too good to be a Muslim. He was too good to be a Muslim. Imam Shamil rahimahullah, as a child, he would spend much of his time in the masjid. He would learn the Quran, the Sunnah. He was a man who did a lot of dhikr. He was actually a Sufi. He belonged to the Naqshbandiya Khalidiyya Tariqa. The Naqshbandiya Khalidiyya Tariqa. When it came into the Caucasus, there were many pagan habits in the Muslims, many bid'at. And it was the Naqshbandiya Khalidiyya Tariqa which actually expunged this. Physically, what was Imam Shamil like? Physically, Imam Shamil was actually a very weak young man. But academically, he was very good. And he was very pious to the degree that he spent much of his time in the masjid. And his father actually used to drink. And this would eat up Imam Shamil rahimahullah. So one day, Imam Shamil took out his dagger. And he said to his father, he said, Wallahi, I feel like killing myself when I see you drinking. And this had a deep impact on his father and he stopped drinking. Academically, Imam Shamil excelled. In the understanding of the Quran and the Sunnah, Imam Shamil excelled to the degree that his colleagues became jealous. And one day, they ambushed him and they beat him senseless. They even stabbed him. Now amongst the people of the Caucasus, it was a sign of weakness that when you are beaten up, that you run to your parents. You don't do that. So what did he do? He crawled into the forest and then he healed his wounds with herbs and he got better and then he came back. And this was the changing point in the life of Imam Shamil rahimahullah. After this, he became the warrior. They say, no man could run like Imam Shamil. No man could ride a horse like Imam Shamil. No man could swim like Imam Shamil. No man could fight like Imam Shamil. You know how they would train? They would put a bullet on their tongue or a pebble on their tongue. And they would run for miles and miles. And if you panted, and the bullet fell down, that meant that you were not fit enough today. You weren't fit enough yet. Imam Shamil rahimahullah, he could jump over a stream which was 27 feet. He could leap over the shoulder of a person. As far as strength, Imam Shamil was 6'3". They say that he could split the butt of a rifle with one strike. In one of the battles, one of the Cossack horsemen, Imam Shamil rahimullah, struck him with a sword from the head and he literally split him into two, right down to his butt. Right down to his butt. As while riding a horse, Imam Shamil rahimahullah, he would have a rifle in one hand, a sword in the other hand, and he would control the horse. The reins would be in his mouth. And this is how he would control the horse. He could come down from the horse, come down to the belly and come up from the other side. This is what these people were like. The London Times defined Imam Shamil as the greatest chieftain who ever lived. The Times, 150 years ago, wrote so many articles on Imam Shamil that the article, the cuttings reached him in the mountains of the Caucasus. The mountains of the Caucasus.